It is 6 o'clock on July 21st. I'm going to commence the regularly scheduled board meeting for Brent Sporting Fire Protection District. We will begin with a Pledge of Allegiance, and then we'll move into a moment of silence for the victims of school shootings in our nation right now. If you'll join me. I pledge allegiance, to the flag, of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. We'll take our moment of silence. Okay, thank you. All right, as we commence, Chief Lackey, will you administer the roll call, please?
Director Dodds.
Aye, present.
Director Vanris.
Present.
Director Landon.
Here.
Director Meyer.
Here.
And Director O'Connell is absent.
Thank you, Chief. I'm going to ask for Mr. Serrano to provide a quick overview of the process that we were in our virtual meetings right now.
Thank you, Vice Chair Dodds. Under the pre-reorganization agreement that this board has adopted, as well as LAFCO and Scotts Valley Fire, LAFCO staff is providing admin help in any way we can, including administering these virtual meetings. Under this virtual process, the staff and board have complete control over your webcams and microphones. For members of the public, their microphones and webcams have been disabled, but they still have an opportunity to view and see the entire meeting. They also have the ability to ask questions during public comment on any agenda item. And how that will work is, once they are recognized by the vice chair, they'll have up to 3 minutes to address the commission or address the board. And they can raise their hand, clicking on the raise hand button. If they're on the conference call, they can press *9 and that will raise their hand. I will let them know when they have 1 minute left and when their time is up. And in accordance with AB 361, any action by this board will require a roll call vote. So your chief will do a roll call when you have to take action. But Vice Chair, that completes the update. I'd be happy to answer any questions.
Thank you. Any board member have any questions on the process? Chief Lackey? Nope. Great. I'm gonna move to item two, agenda amendments. Chief, you have the floor.
Yes, I have one item. I believe I emailed all of you a resolution 2022-5 resolution ordering an election from the county elections. I'd like to add that to the consent agenda 4.4.
Okay, thank you, Chief. Any other amendments to the agenda? Hearing none, we'll move on. Item number three. Chief, do we have any requests to address the board on non-agenda items this evening?
I have not received any.
And we don't see any requests at this time either.
Thank you, Mr. Serrano. We'll move on to our consent calendar, item number four. Going to approve the regular board meeting minutes of June 16th, 2022. We'll ratify resolution number 2022-1, which is to continue remote meetings during this time of COVID. Item number 4.3, approve Branson 40 Fire Department claims disbursement for the month of June 1st through June 30, 2022. Those totals for those claims are a payroll and benefit of $93,463.34. The general fund, $8,429.91. A Measure T of $2,000 for a total of $103,893.25. We're also adding 4.4, the resolution 2022-5 regarding elections. Do I have a motion to accept the consent calendar?
I'll make a motion to approve the consent calendar 4.1 through 4.4.
Moves. Do we have a second?
I'll make the second.
Director Langdon seconds.
That was Director Meyer.
Okay. Voices, no faces. Okay. All right.
All right. Do we need a voice vote for this, I believe?
Yes, we do. Go ahead, Chief.
Director Dodds?
Aye.
Director Vanris?
Aye.
Director Landon?
Aye.
Director Meyer?
Aye.
And Director O'Connell is absent.
All right. The motion passes. Move on to item number 5. We have one item tonight that requires some discussion, and that is 5.1, the benefit assessment study. And I ask for a presentation to that. Is that you, Chief, or Mr. Serrano that provides that?
I can do this if you like. So we put out a RFP several months ago for the benefit assessment regarding what's it going to cost to keep the station open. We sent it out to 20 or 30 companies. We received one proposal back. SCI Consulting Group, reviewing all their past contracts and references. We feel that they're a very qualified consulting firm, and they are within the budget that we budgeted for. So I recommend that we approve their proposal. Are there any questions on the proposal?
Yeah, hello, this is Landon.
Yes, sir. Go ahead.
I want to know what Scotts Valley parcel fire taxes are currently right now per parcel.
Scotts Valley's?
Anybody know?
Not that I'm aware of. I don't think they have any.
They don't pay anything. They don't have a special tax.
Really?
Yeah.
Because we doubled our tax on our citizens, 3 years ago, right?
Well, I wouldn't say doubled. We went, I don't know what it was previous, but Measure T is 200 per parcel.
It was 100. It was previously 100. We doubled it on every citizen.
Okay. I don't remember, but sure, I'll go. I'm not sure of that. Okay.
Anyway, I'm not trying to be belligerent or anything. You guys know my position on this. I don't think it's fair for us to push any additional burden on our community, especially when everybody's getting their, not everyone, but quite a few people are, because of the CZU fire, they're getting their fire insurance canceled and might have to enter the California emergency plan, which doubles or triples their cost usually. I'm a victim of that right now myself. In any case, and I haven't found anything quite suitable, it's going to be a hard nut to crack just for my, for our household here. So I'm not ready to approve this particular item. I don't agree from the beginning about it. I refused. I also voted against it to seek out an RFP investigation or quotes. I guess we only got one quote also, which is interesting. In any case, I feel as though we're at a precipice here in the community. Obviously, there is some arm bending going on. And now the arm bending is coming to us, and we have to arm bend the community. And I don't think it's right. I think our record so far has been, I'm not going to say perfect or exemplary even, but adequate. We are a rural community. As I said previously too, that it's my understanding that Scotts Valley can cover 80% of the area within 5 minutes, which is usually adequate for most fire insurance companies. That's my understanding. And I don't understand why we have to even submit such a plan. And that's how I feel. And you guys probably already know that, but I just wanted to make it part of public record. Thank you.
Mr. Serrano, do you want to respond to that, or?
Yes, thank you, Vice Chair. If you don't mind, I'll chime in. And I completely understand Board Member Landon's comments. And actually, what we've been hearing from the residents is concerns about the fire station. What happens to the fire station if this reorganization happens? And it was clear that current funding will not be enough to keep the fire station operating with at least a two-member crew. So the question is, well, how much is it going to cost to keep the fire station open with a two-member crew? And that's why we're trying to get this benefit study completed so that we can tell the residents it's going to cost you X amount to keep the fire station open with a two-member crew and leave it up to the residents to see whether or not the fire station remains in operation. If the residents vote no on this benefit assessment, then Board Member Lennon's absolutely right. Scotts Valley Fire can provide services with or without the Branson 40 Fire Station in operation. But the question is, what does the residents want? Do they want their fire station to be in operation? If so, how much is it going to cost? And the only way we can do that is to do this study. So again, there's value in having this study completed. And at the end of the day, it's going to be the residents who vote whether or not they want to approve this assessment. And again, this reorganization will happen, and Scotts Valley Fire will either provide services with their existing fire stations, or they'll have it with their existing fire station plus the Branson 40 Fire Station. But it'll be up to the residents, and this study will be able to provide that information to them.
I would just like to make one more comment, and then I'll shut up.
All right, go ahead.
Mr. Serrano, made the impression that if this tax assessment passes and the people, once we come up with a number and we know what the number is going to be, more or less, we have a feeling for it, where it's going to be a lot of money. Okay. And then the other thing is that he made the impression that if this was to pass, that the residents could count on Branson 40 being two-man staffed by Scotts Valley. I fail at this point to hear any assurances long-term of that or permanently of that situation. If that is going to be etched in stone, I'm sure the residents would like to know that. So I don't know if Joe is ready to step up or anybody in Scotts Valley to say that, okay, we pass this rather large tax bill, and I'm just being honest, it's not going to be a little bill, it's going to be a big bill, that station is guaranteed for as long as Scotts Valley's running this area, will be open and staffed with the two man plus the paramedic plus forever. Anyway, that's my last comment. Thank you.
And I'll just chime in again. Again, another great comment and question from the board member Landon. And yes, if the residents approve this assessment, the devil's in the detail. So as long as we make sure that the language in this assessment says that this money is only going to stay within Branson 40 community and only to ensure that there's at least two member crew at the fire station, that way it's clear in the language that the money being collected from the Branson 40 residents is for the fire station to remain in operation with a two member crew. And in addition to the benefit assessment, LAFCO can include terms and conditions in the resolution. So again, to reassure the residents that this money is not going to be part of Scotts Valley Fire's general fund and used for other issues other than Branson 40. I want that reassurance to the residents, and they should have that, especially if they do decide to pay an additional fund to keep in operation. There needs to be a reassurance, and LAFCO is a vehicle to make sure that that happens.
Thank you, Mr. Serrano.
So we're saying here that in the event that Scotts Valley annexes us into their department, that there's no way that they can take the money from the taxpayers of Happy Valley and Branson 40 Fire Department and use it for their general fund.
I'll go ahead and respond real quick, okay. Mr. Serrano. So kind of reiterate the same thing that Mr. Serrano was saying, that the first step in all of this is to find out what is this going to cost. If we wanted to keep the station and have it manned, have it fully staffed according to the parameters that we set, we have to know that information in order to take the next step. And then in the negotiation of how we proceed from there, it will be up to LAFCO and to us to write in the terms and conditions of how we would move forward. And if we get to a point where we're not comfortable, then we're not comfortable. Or if we've got everything in there that the residents and the board feel comfortable enough, we'll move forward. But until we know what this would cost, we're not able to move forward with any kind of a negotiation that has enough substance to it to move forward. Other questions, comments?
Yeah, I have a question, comment.
Go ahead.
In reading over their proposal, I didn't see a time frame. So is that kind of open, or did they give you a guesstimate as to how long this might take? Because what would not be good is for, you know, we're slowing down, slow to get this assessment done. And then we got to speed up, hurry up. And well, I hope it's not tried to be pushed through. So I hope there's ample time once this is done to get it out to the property owners with workshops, et cetera, et cetera. Also, I would suggest at least a postcard going out prior to explain where we're at, and another follow-up one, obviously, when we're ready to start talking about the, you know, setting up the workshops and that sort of thing.
Point well taken. Mr. Serrano.
Another great comment, and you're absolutely right, Board Member Veneris, of informing the residents, and that's something that Chief and I were going to touch on this later in the agenda of the joint ad hoc committee is working on a flyer to informing the residents on what's going on right now and what's going to be coming up soon and really setting the stage to have these workshops. But you're absolutely right about providing information to the residents. And if this board approves this contract, one of the first thing that the chief and I will do is meet with SCI Consulting and develop a schedule so we know exactly what our expectations is, when this study is going to be done, when is it going to be provided to the board, and when it's going to be provided to the residents. I think we need to develop that as soon as possible, so that way we're all on the same page on when this data is going to be available.
When is this proposal going to ballot or scheduled to?
This proposal is handled by the board and approved by the board to hire SCI. So if we take action tonight, then we will approve this. We can choose to approve this and then move forward with exactly what Mr. Serrano was just talking about, developing a schedule. Did I speak correctly on that, Mr. Serrano?
Yes, would that go to a general election or a special election?
So assuming that the board approves this agreement and assuming the SEI completes the assessment, the study, then the next step is scheduling the election, and it's a special election, so it's a mail-in ballot. So once the information is ready to go, we send the ballots out to the residents and then they vote on it. When is that going to occur? That's yet to be determined. That's why we want to schedule a meeting with the SCI consulting to develop a schedule. But the first step is to get approval to have those conversations with them.
Lastly, on my comment would be not having, or when we hurry up to get this out to the community, the property owners, I don't want to see that pushed. I want there to be plenty of time there between a reorganization. So obviously that could be pushed out, the reorganization. But I want to see enough time that everybody gets to them. And I have absolutely no idea. I thought I saw maybe 10 participants tonight. So it doesn't look like a lot of people are tuning in. So that's why, you know, the flyers and getting out to every parcel obviously is the best way to get out to everyone. Yeah, anyway, that's my thought on that, is making sure there's enough time to properly go over all this information. Because it is, I imagine it's going to be a lot, like Director Landon did specify. We talked about numbers last year, but the scope is much larger. So it's going to be more. That's all I have to say about that.
I had one more comment.
Sure, go ahead.
This is Director Landon. The cost of this is going to be really a lot. I mean, we're right away, we're throwing out, what is it, $54,000 for the SCI just to do the assessment and how much it's going to cost. I mean, the number of $1,000 per parcel addition to everybody in Happy Valley and in Branch 40 will be added to their current annual tax bill. Realistically, at these times, and our fire taxes, our fire insurance costs that are not reflective on this at all. I propose that. I know it, that the insurance companies are just reacting to the SCU fire and the Paradise fire, and they can do it any which way they want to. And I will make a slight argument to what Joe said about, I mean, I thought it was very cogent that Director Myers brought up the idea of not mixing monies with Scotts Valley. I'm sorry, I haven't been in government too long, but I know enough to know that you can't bring two pools together, you separate two pools from this. So, you know, like, trying to leave the impression, I just don't trust it. That's my instinct, and I think a lot of residents probably would have the same instinct. And to those means, I would propose something more avant-garde, you might say, to this whole LAFCO arm twisting and annexing, et cetera, et cetera. Nothing against you, Joe. That's life in the government fast lane. I would propose, why don't we, you know, it's obvious the Scotts Valley is not even paying a dime according to Director Branares, that they're paying a dime. We're paying $200 a parcel now here. They're a huge area. Why don't we share that? We know the money's going to be blended. We know the money is going to pass through that impermeable barrier that we might be talking about right now, and whatever we put in solid language. I'm sorry, I still don't trust it. Why don't we get Scotts Valley and Happy Valley to, I'm ready to pay SCI some more money, you know, get them to share it so we don't get killed so badly. And let's spread the misery a little bit. And that's my last comment. Thank you. Well, maybe it's my last. Thank you.
Sure. No worries. Is there any public comments? I'm seeing any hands, Mr. Serrano, Mr. Lackey, Chief?
Vice Chair Dawes, there is a request from Ms. Marilyn. If you'd like, I can unmute her.
Sure. Go ahead.
Okay. Ms. Marilyn, you've been asked to be unmuted. And you have up to 3 minutes.
Have I successfully unmuted?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Yeah, I just wanted to make a couple very simple comments. I understand the hesitancy to spend money on the consulting group, but as a member of the public, I would just like to say, I think the only way that the public at large in the district is going to be able to accept the numbers that come out without saying there's a bias from Branson 40 or Scotts Valley is to have an independent consulting group provide those numbers without bias. And the only other question is, Mr. Serrano, could you outline the public outreach on this for us? I don't know whether there's a specific timetable, but at least the steps. Thank you.
And Vice Chair Dodds, I would just note that the Joint Ad Hoc Committee is working on rolling out these workshops, but the first thing that we want to make sure that we have the same data. We're all on the same page when it comes to rolling out information. So the Joint Ad Hoc Committee is really working hard on getting consensus on the preliminary data to share with the residents. And we're hoping that a flyer can be sent out in August and hopefully start having these workshops by August, September. But going back to Board Member Pete Vanaris's comments of not rushing it, and LAFCO agrees 100%. I don't want to give the impression to the residents that this is being forced on them without any opportunity to voice their concerns or hear information. There is no rush in getting this reorganization. In fact, I want to make sure that it's done correctly and transparently. So if this takes a year to complete, it takes a year. We want to make sure that we give the true facts to the residents, give them enough opportunities to understand and educate them about the benefits of this reorganization. And even though we only see 5 members of the public at this board meeting, it doesn't mean that we're not going to cut corners and try to get this done as quickly as possible. No, we're going to do everything we can to provide the information to them, either by mail, through these virtual meetings, doing hybrids, in-person workshops. We're going to do everything we can to inform the residents, and and it's going to take time. And if we're going to do it this right, we need time. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Serrano.
Chairman?
Yes.
Chairman, this is Director Landon. I agree with Joe 100%. We should give the residents as much time, and Director Vanessa, that we really should let everybody know what's going on right now, like a postcard, a flyer, like we usually do, let everybody know, hey, this is coming your way. And, it could be a big wave or it could be nothing. I don't know, but it's going to be something. And right now we have one estimate from one company. I don't get that, but okay. SCI, I guess they have lots of credos. Great. But what I'm saying is that's 50K right now. So, I mean, are people really realizing what we're up to? I don't think so. I would say maybe 1 out of 10 in our district that really knows what's, you know, what the snowball roll is coming at them. Especially in these times, fellas, these times where the fire insurance is just tripling on people. I mean, we have to let people know what's coming down the pike, and we have to do it now. We have to do it before we vote on this. That's what I think. I think we're ahead of ourselves here, and it's getting pushed, just like Pete said, it's getting pushed a little bit. And Myers also knows it's getting pushed a little bit, and he wants assurances. I would like to see some assurances right now, kind of like preliminary, like things that Joe is saying to go out to everyone. And so that we could have a lot more public feedback, because without total public feedback right now, like I said, I'm not voting for this right now. I need to hear from a lot of people in the public and what they're thinking, if they're ready to swallow this big nut. Okay, thank you.
Well, I would just add to that, that the public committees have been meeting and discussing this, and that broader knowledge of what's going on than what you might think. That Citizens Committee is very aware that the next step, and this is coming from back to the first of the year, is to at least have the data in hand on what the costs would be. This obligates us to nothing, but what it does is provides the data for us to sit back down at the table with then the citizens, all of our residents, and say, here is what it will take. And then we can begin to negotiate from a position of power of knowing, and from that inform the public. So I'm really hoping that we'll pass this and let another month go by without starting to get this data in place, so that we can then strategically and intentionally make our next steps. I don't feel like this has been rushed, as we've known for this RFP went out a couple of months ago, and our citizens committees that have been meeting are aware, and they talk. They're talking to their neighbors, to other residents. So I'm hoping that we can pass this and move forward with this process. Anyone else have a comment?
Chairman, I'd like to respond to that, please.
Sure.
Last meeting, LAFCO said, or inferred or suggested, that they were going to give us minutes on the citizens meetings and the ad hoc meetings. We were going to get some kind of minutes from LAFCO. Maybe I wrote that down wrong. I also will counter you on your statement that it's not costing anything. It's costing $50,000. And I want everybody out there to know, if the citizens, I'm a director, right? Okay, I have not got anything from the citizens group and what the feedback is from them. So I know you have your ear a little closer as the vice chair, and Pat, as a chair, closer to the ground, you hear this feedback. That's great. That's just dandy. But I want to know how many people are saying, yeah, let's go with $1,000 increase possibly on every assessment in this county. And last time Becky Steinbrenner was on, she said that these voting mechanisms, these special benefit assessments, they're very interesting the way they get passed. I wonder if that was really talked about at a really low, a high level. Those are my two contentions on what you just said. Yes, we all want to move this forward. We want successful, all around beneficial, whatever. But right now we're looking at a $50,000 bill. I haven't heard directly as director anything from these committees. I thought there was going to be some minutes. And I know I'm repeating myself now, so thank you very much.
Any other comments this time?
Well, just curious, I know we're getting later in the agenda to like director's report. Is there anything coming up to address what Director Landon was just talking about? Is there a report on the Citizens Committee?
We have not met. The Citizens Committee hasn't met since before the last board meeting.
Okay. Ad hoc committee has met, right?
Correct.
Okay, so you'd be updating on that. Okay.
Chief Lackey or Mr. Serrano, is there information from that last meeting that would be relevant for our discussion here tonight?
Or at least right now.
Yeah, the chief and I were going to provide an update on the joint ad hoc committee later in the agenda, but I will note that the joint ad hoc committee has been meeting. We just had a meeting last month, and the focus on that meeting was twofold. One was developing a matrix or a summary of the benefits of the reorganization and kind of answering some frequently asked questions of residents of what happens to the ISO rating and what's the call data and what's going to be the funding. So we answer those questions in this table. And what we're trying to do is get consensus from Grants Authority, Scotts Valley, and LAFCO on this data, again, so that we're all on the same page. The second item that was discussed at the meeting was, when are we going to have these committee workshops? And we came back to the, well, before we have the workshops, we need to have the data. And not meaning the data of the benefit assessment study, but the data of the overall reorganization of, you know, what is the benefits of this? Why are we doing this? And we really want to tell the story of how do we got here? And the issue is, you know, Brands of 40, you're doing everything you can, but it's not common that LAFCO is coming in to provide admin assistance on Zoom meetings. Special districts have their staff to do that. But, you know, there was issues on even hiring a fire chief. Right now you have a temporary fire chief because, again, there's issues with the current structure. So that's the reasons why we're even discussing reorganization. But a lot of residents don't know that or don't know the issues. So we have to make sure that we tell the story correctly. And that's why we're meeting with this joint ad hoc committee to get that story straight. So that's just a quick overview on what we discussed at our last meeting. And we'll continue having these meetings so that all three parties, Brands of 40, Scotts Valley, and LAFCO, are working together on making sure that we do this successfully and appropriately.
Thank you, Mr. Serrano. Chief Lackey, any other comments on this agenda item?
No, I just, going back to why we need to do this is, one of the main comments we've heard from residents, not just from the resident committee, but in my times speaking with residents is the bottom line is how much is it going to cost me? And, you know, we discussed all of that with the ad hoc committee. And, you know, we kind of came to the conclusion that's the biggest part in most people's mind is how much is it going to cost? You know, yes, we know it's going to cost some money, more money than it does already, but, you know, we can't give them an estimate or a guess. We have to give them a solid number for them to understand and let them make the choice whether they want to spend the money for it or not. And then we can move on from there. So we really can't move forward with this unless we have the numbers and you know, all the other data that goes along with it. And again, this is just to get the data. This isn't saying we are going to move forward.
Right. Thank you, Chief Lackey. We have motion number 5.1 in front of us. Right.
Hold on, Tim, just to go back, I did notice that there was a hand up and it went down because, you know, the directors were and everybody was talking. I think it was Marilyn raised her hand again. Just wanted to make sure if she had something else to say before we make a motion on this.
Sure. Thank you, Pete.
Vice Chair, would you like to for me to unmute her once again?
Yes, please.
Okay. Ms. Marilyn, you've been asked to be unmuted.
Yes, thanks. I just wanted to say to Director Brandon, I mean, I totally agree with you about the concerns of transparency about minutes and things, and I agree, but I also would like to second what Director Dodds and Chief Lackey said is the study needs to happen so that the public has independent confirmation of what the costs would be to keep the station open. And the last thing is the low attendance just might be because the January 6th hearings are going on right now. I don't think it's lack of interest overall. Thank you.
We have a motion before us. Do I have anyone that will move this motion?
I'll make a motion to approve agreement with SCI Consulting Group.
We have a motion. Do I have a second? Not hearing a second. I do need to ask a moment of clarification of procedure. Perhaps Mr. Serrano can answer this. As Vice Chair, am I able to second a motion on the floor?
Yes, you can entertain a motion if you were the Chair or Vice Chair. As a Director, you can second the motion as well.
Okay, thank you. I'll second the motion. And Chief Lackey, will you do a voice vote?
Okay, voice vote. Director Dodds.
Aye.
Director Van Riss.
Aye.
Director Landon.
Nay.
Director Meyer.
Nay.
And Director O'Connell's absent.
So this item has failed. We will revisit this item at the August regularly scheduled board meeting, unless we choose to do an additional meeting in the interim. All right, moving on to item number 6.1, operational update. Chief, can you give us your update, please?
I put in your packet a little letter describing what's been going on. So right now, working on to complete the final budget for 2022-23.
I don't recall specific asks, just anything you could do. Again, I got this.
Mute, Marilyn, there you go. All right. So I'm working to complete the final budget for 2022-23. I'm waiting for the county to get back with our numbers from last year. Should have that in the next week or so. I do have in my hand the permit for the kitchen remodel. As of now, we're on hold. A big item that we're working on in the county is the new fire code for 2022-20 for 3 years. It's a three-year cycle that we have to do. It's a pretty arduous task that we have to go through the over 60 chapters and 15 amendments to the whole fire code. We're working with all the prevention officers and in every department in the county to work on this to make it a single county fire code this year versus each individual district having to adopt their own code, which will simplify everything and help other contractors or residents from kind of shopping around to see if they can get something work for them. So we're probably a couple weeks out finishing that up, and then we'll have to take it to the Board of Supervisors to work with that. The new website is just about to roll out. I believe I sent you all the link to kind of review it and let me know if you have any questions on that. And then for those of you who live past the station or gone by the station, the new sign is up. I think it looks good. We have to run some electrical to it, and then we'll be able to have it lit up at night as well. So if you guys have any questions, comments on anything that I just reviewed?
That sounds all good to me. I do have just would like a status update on the sale and purchase of the old Equinox and a new truck. Where are we at on that process? That was approved last month.
So we've put the Equinox up on Craigslist a couple days ago. Haven't got anything yet. I did purchase a truck actually today for about $36,000. So we're moving on that. So hopefully we'll get the Equinox sold in the next week or so.
What were you able to get?
2019 Chevy 1500, four-wheel drive, great. Crew cab. So
great, crew cab.
Yep.
Great. Any other questions for anyone else?
Chief Lackey, this is Landon. I was wondering if you'd give me a status update on, you know, we put some money aside quite a bit to get our volunteers to step up and become captains or full, you know, basically, I don't know how you're putting it, the fill captains. Where are we with that?
We have three full-time volunteer firefighters, so they're all working a shift along with the captains and myself. All the shifts have been filled, and it's wonderful having two people here 24/7 with us.
Great.
That is good, yeah. One other thing, I was just a little maybe off center, but I was wondering if Nate has heard anything about the fire.
It's out in Oromas, and I'm actually getting updates as we talk. And they're looking for equipment. We haven't had a request in our county yet for anything, but we're all ready to go.
Are they using any planes on it with water?
They have dumped a lot of aircraft on it, yes.
Awesome. Thank you.
Yep.
Chief, also wondering the status on the building itself, the structural piece of the repair that's needed. Any update on that?
I have not received an update from the contractor. Last he said he was waiting to hear back from the engineer and then take it to the county for approval. So that's, as far as I know, it's still moving forward. I plan on checking in with him next week to see where we're at. So
super, thanks.
Chairman Dodd, I had a question about that too. I thought in the last meeting we were going to put all those building expenses on hold temporarily. Is that true still?
We were going to put the kitchen remodel on hold. So that isn't going anywhere. But the repair of the station is still moving forward.
Oh, is that the structural repair?
Correct.
Okay. Okay, great. Thanks.
Okay. All right. Item 6.2, we touched on that a little bit. Mr. Serrano, Mr. Lackey, anything additional to add on the last meeting regarding the reorganization between Branson 40 and Scotts Valley?
I believe we've hit that pretty good, so.
Great. I don't see Mr. Serrano unmuting himself, so we'll move on to item 7, Board of Directors report. I have nothing to add at this point. Anyone else on the board? All right, we'll move on to the staffing report with Chief Lackey.
Excuse me, Chairman, I had one thing.
Yes, go ahead.
I'd like to propose an action item for next time that we might discuss or whatever it takes. I would like to have these Zoom meetings recorded for the public so they can access them off our website. Thank you.
Okay. I know they're currently being recorded. Mr. Serrano, is that something that we're able to do?
Yes, if I get direction from your chief or if the board wants to take formal action, LAFCO has a YouTube channel where we upload all our meeting recordings. So if, rather than storing these very large files in your website, an alternative would be just having accessible on LAFCO's YouTube channel free of cost. So that's something that, you know, this board can take formal action, or if I get direction from your chief, I can start having those accessible on that channel.
Okay, that's a great suggestion. We'll move forward with the proposal and have that available to us the next board meeting. Any other items on 7.1? Hearing none, we'll go on to 7.2.
You should have in front of you the staffing report and the apparatus report. If you have any questions, I can answer.
Great. Hearing none, we'll move forward. Item number 8. Chief, have we received any written correspondence?
You should have in front of you a letter from the negotiating committee to Captain Lucchese regarding negotiations, and a letter from Ms. Marilyn Coots regarding FireWise, and a thank you. And that's all that I've received.
Great. I'd like to, pursuant to the letter from Marilyn Coots, I'd like to go ahead and read that for the record. That's all right. Hats off to Captain Perez. Happy Valley FireWise gives you a big salute of thanks for your presentation at a recent community meeting. It was obvious that you put a lot of thought and preparation time into your presentation. It was both valuable and well-received. You've been a great asset to our FireWise community, not only for your presentation at our meeting, but for all your inspections and assistance with helping us form our Happy Valley FireWise group. We can't thank you enough. Marilyn Cooch. Thank you, Marilyn. Appreciate that. And many thanks to Captain Perez as well. The correspondence from Chair O'Connell lays out the process for beginning the negotiations for the new contract. Directors, I believe you all have that copy. So enter that into, it's already in the packet. Right. Move on to number 9, good of the odor. Any staff or board have any items here before for the good of order? Hearing none, I'll accept a motion to adjourn.
I'll make a motion to adjourn this meeting with our next regularly scheduled board meeting Thursday, August 18th, 2022.
All right, is there a second?
Yeah, I'll second that. This is Landon.
Thank you, Dick. And hearing no other voice, we'll assume that we're all ready to end this meeting. I thank you very much. We will reconvene on August 18th, 6 o'clock. Of 2022. Thank you, everyone.